Welcome back to another video. As always, if this is the kind of topic you like, please like and subscribe, comment, drop a dislike if you don't like the video. That's fine too. We're going to stick to the Christian topic for the next few videos. I mentioned that I was going to do a book review of five different books, and I'm going to start with a book by the late Nabeel Qureshi, Seeking Allah, Finding Jesus. It is a testimony and a story about Nabeel. It's an autobiography in which he details how he eventually converted from Islam to Christianity at a huge cost. He essentially sacrificed the relationships with his family. I believe his sister was okay with it, but his parents, especially his dad, were never really the same after that. His dad's heart was broken. And I mean, he really, that's how important this was to him. The book starts off as somewhat of a summary of Nabeel's life, his family history. He is Urdu, which I believe is a, correct me if I'm wrong, but it's a Pakistani, clan, tribe, family, race. That is where, his family was from. He, however, and his sister were both born in America, and as he put it, westernized, which was hard for their parents, right? It's definitely a shock for Arabic and Middle Eastern parents who are Muslim to come to America and see how their kids are raised, and no matter how they influence them, they cannot, for the most part, help their kids from being quote-unquote westernized, you know, used to our language, our culture, our norms. How many Muslim girls do you know? Maybe you don't know any, but I grew up with plenty here where I am who identified as Muslim but did not wear any kind of headscarf, you know? They wanted to be sexy with all the other girls. Muslim was just their religion. Anyway, Nabeel talks a lot about the differences between Islam and Christianity. He talks about certain things that I find very interesting, including the fact that Islamic people have a affinity for dreams. I didn't realize that, but dreams are a way that God communicates. At least that's what they believe. And I won't give away too much, but Nabeel, he essentially is, with the help of David Wood, converted to Christianity and put to the test over and over again. The book will actually introduce you to David Wood, who is possibly one of the best Christian apologetics out there. Apologetics being a art of debating and arguing for the existence of God and the support of the Christian faith being a real religion and Jesus being real and all that, right? So David Wood is a friend of Nabeel's, and over time, over the years of their relationship, he constantly challenges Nabeel on, you know, certain things about Islam and why Christianity is a real religion and Islam is not so real, not so good. And, eventually Nabeel asks God to prove it to him. And I won't give away everything that happens because, I mean, I'm not trying to ruin the book, but God does show him more than, I think, two or three times the light of Christianity. And Nabeel eventually caves and he does convert. And, like I said, it cost him a huge price. I said the book is really good for a number of reasons. One, people might not understand the differences between atheism, Islam, and Christianity, right? So it's good if you want to know from a Christian perspective what Islamic people believe, what's written in the Quran. Writings from the Quran were essentially used to convince Nabeel that it wasn't a good religion. David didn't just use the Bible to help him along. He quoted the Quran itself. And the book is also good for being an introduction to David Woods. David Woods, his YouTube channel is called Act 17 Apologetics. I think he's got like under 500,000 subscribers. It won't be long before he's kicked off YouTube, I'm sure. But yeah, essentially a very, very good person to study from. The only thing about Woods, though, and Nabeel eventually diverted from this path as well, but Woods has a very strong focus on arguing with Muslims. He is not necessarily the guy you go to if you want to just talk about the existence of God, the existence of Jesus. He's more about the guy that's like, this is why, you know, Christianity is better than Islam and why Christianity is real and Islam is a fake religion. That kind of stuff. It's very good info to know, but at a certain point, you're limited to just that. And Nabeel, not written in his book, but Nabeel eventually leaves the organization that he is a part of with David because that's David's purpose. That's what he focuses on. And Nabeel wanted to bring other people to Jesus, not just Muslims. And at a certain point, he leaves the org that him and David started so he could do that. Now, sadly, Nabeel died. I think about 3 or 4 years ago now, he was diagnosed with stomach cancer and it took him very quickly. It's very, very sad. I will say he does mention in his book that he was a food, not like a food junkie. He wasn't ever fat, like at least not in the videos that I saw of him, but he ate a lot of food. He would be like kind of like an endless pit type guy who would just gorge on food. And I don't know if that's what ended up killing him, but it is interesting to note that he talks about that in his book. And then there's a note at the end of his book that he died from stomach cancer. Nabeel's wife is still out there in the public eye. David Wood is still out there for sure. But I highly recommend this book as someone who might be if you're someone who might be thinking about becoming a Christian and, you know, and why become a Christian over become a Muslim, for example. But yeah, I think that'll do it. You know, just a short review on this book. Overall, I thought it was a very good book. It's written in a funny way. You're not going to feel bored reading it. You're not going to have to reread lines. You'll feel engaged and that it's an entertaining read for sure. Yeah, that'll do it. I got 4 more book reviews coming up. See ya.